everyone. Thanks for tuning in.
Hello, hello, hello. I'm Lanmo, the one with the top hat.
And I'm Wallace, the one with the derby.
Yeah. Oh, I wonder who that is.
I'm Gerald, the one with the talent. Okay, all right, move over. Give me room, bonzos. I'm taking over. I shall start by reciting a poem, The Sugar Plum Tree by Eugene Field. Have you ever heard of the sugar plum tree? 'Tis a marvel of great renown. It blooms on the shore of the Lollipop Sea. When in...
Hold it! We don't have time for your poem. Sorry.
Wait a minute. What are you talking about? Sorry, you don't have time. Eugene Field had time to write it. You don't have time for me to recite.
We got a full lineup, a tight schedule. We're overbooked.
Yeah, look, if I don't get to recite my poem right now, I'm walking out and I may never come back again. Hey, what do you say? What do you say to that?
Sorry, no poem.
No poem.
Gerald. There we go. Say goodbye to him, audience. Hey, don't worry about Gerald. He'll get over it. He'll be back later in the show.
Yeah. Hey, Wall Boy, is it okay if I go see Marshall Good?
You gonna go see Marshall Good?
Yeah, right now, okay?
All right.
I'll see you in a little while.
All right. Say, why don't we join Ladmo and Marshall Good and see what they're up to?
Howdy, Marshall Good. How you doing there?
Howdy, 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 howdy.
Howdy, 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 howdy.
Howdy, howdy, howdy. Howdy. Look, ambidextrous.
I just thought I'd pay a visit, you know.
Who says I'm not versatile?
Guess what? What would I give up? What?
It's Old Cowboy Week.
No! Old Cowboy
Yes,
Week? How do we celebrate Old Cowboy Week?
If an old cowboy knocks on your door asking for old furniture, old groceries, you gotta help him out.
Ah, I see.
It's a worthy cause, you see.
Yeah. That's it?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay.
I'm just gonna go out the side door. I'll see you later.
Okay, Marshall Good. Old Cowboy Week. Boy. Somebody's knocking at the door. I wonder who it could be.
Howdy, howdy, howdy. Howdy,
howdy, howdy, howdy. Howdy.
It's me, your neighborhood old cowboy.
Well, I'm sorry, I haven't got any old furniture or old groceries, you know.
No, that's okay. I'll take old money.
Old money? Well, all I have is just one.
Oh, and very old, too. It looks like a collectible to me.
Well, yeah, it's got...
That's fine, bless you. Remember, it's a worthy cause.
Yeah, but...
Maybe now would be a good time to go through some of the mail. Hey, we got pictures of Gerald, and, what is this? Oh, it's a note from Ladmo. Dear Wallace, catch you later. I'm on my way to see Aunt Maud, signed Ladmo. Well, I guess Ladmo's on his way over to Aunt Maud's right now.
Next morning, there's a huge beanstalk reaching up to the sky.
Wait a minute, just a minute. Well, hold that, Maud. I've heard that story before.
Not the way I tell it.
Are you telling a different way?
Now, clam up, Ladmo. Let's see, where was I? Oh, yes. Jack climbed up the beanstalk and got off at the first cloud. He ran over to the castle and slipped inside. There was the giant and the hen that laid golden eggs. Jack waited till the giant fell asleep. Then he swiped the hen. Down the beanstalk he went, and back home again. Jack put the hen in the kitchen and took a nap. He was dreaming about how excited his mom would be to have a hen that laid golden eggs. I mean, let's face it, solid gold eggs would solve all their problems.
Yeah, I've heard the same thing.
After a couple of hours, Jack's mom woke him and said, "Come on, Jack, it's time for lunch. I fried a chicken that I found in the kitchen."
Fried a chicken.
When Jack told her about the golden eggs and how she'd blown their financial security, she became very despondent, stopped talking, and sat facing the wall for 3 years.
I don't blame her. She fed the chicken that laid the golden egg. Poor little like a berry. Oh, somebody's at the door. Come in. Good morning, wizard. Come on in.
I'm telling you, I've been up all night long just making up stuff.
You got it, huh?
Just going through all the files and all the books, coming up with information.
Facts, facts.
Did you know
what?
Sir Isaac Newton didn't get the idea for the law of gravity from a falling apple?
Didn't?
He got a mild concussion.
Really?
Had a headache for days.
Ooh.
Do you know yak tails are the chief export of Tibet? Which explains a ridiculous gross national product of $35.
No fooling.
Did you know the kiwi bird of New Zealand weighs 4 pounds and lays a 5-pound egg, but not very often? And then only if you use a whip.
You're putting me on.
No, I'm telling you, they say, oh, no, not again. Did you know that horses play people's shoes?
I didn't know that.
You know, Genghis Khan never went through basic training?
I'll have to take your word for that one.
Did you know Quasimodo never graduated from Notre Dame?
One more.
You know, Great Bend, Montana is not great,
no,
nor does it bend.
I didn't know that either.
So long, Lambo.
So long, wizard.
They're tuned up and ready to go. I'm talking about Commodore Candelo and the Salt River Navy Band.
Commodore Candelo, Salt River Band.
Ladmo's gone again. I think he went over to see Bobby Joe Trouble.
Bobby Joe Trouble!
Yeah, I've been practicing with my air bike.
Air bike? Oh! Hey, where have you been?
Just riding around, yeah. I've been everywhere.
Everywhere?
I've been everywhere. Ooh. I've been everywhere. And from Red Rock to Green Valley, from White Sands to Yellowstone, from Brownsville to Orange County.
Ooh, sounds like a colorful trip.
Colorful.
Yeah, you get that?
Brownsville, Orange County. Yeah. Hey, Ladmo, that's a good one.
You like that, huh?
Yeah, you're a funny guy.
Hey, right? I'm glad you're in a good mood. Because I want to ask you a question.
Yeah, what's that?
How come you don't trade in your motorcycle for a car and get a regular job like a normal person?
You know, Ladmo, I used to think you were a funny guy, but not anymore.
Oh? Where'd I go wrong?
All right, let me give you an example. Colorful trip, that's funny. Regular job, that's not funny. You're beginning to sound like Edna Troublemaker.
Edna Trouble? Who?
Yeah, my mom.
Oh.
Always saying, get a job, get a job. Get a job, yeah.
Well, why don't you? I mean, you could be, there's plenty of opportunities for, perhaps you could... You're right, Bobby Joe. You better hang on to your Harley.
That's right, Ladmo. I shall keep my bike because I am Bobby Joe Trouble. I am who I am. And you know what else?
What?
I've got to be me.
He's got to be him. See you, Bobby Joe.
If I got some neat photos to show you.
Oh, well, sorry to interrupt.
Well, it's all right. I'm glad you're here because I wanted you to see these. The kids have been sending in photos of themselves and their pets.
The pets?
Yeah, now here's one that came in from Tanya and her pigeon.
Oh, isn't that great? It sits on his shoulder.
And here's Chris and her goose.
Oh, okay. Looks like they're having lunch.
And Andrea has a picture of her kitty. Wearing a football helmet.
Look at that.
And Ashley sent in a photograph of her kitty having lunch.
All right.
Isn't that great?
Isn't that something?
All right.
Okay.
I like these.
Yeah, I do too. Hey, I just wanted you to know I'm ready.
Ready for what?
Spunky, my routine. I'm all set up over there, so you introduce me, okay? I'll get ready.
I'm ready.
Oh, yeah, Ladmo's been practicing to be a ventriloquist, and so I guess we might as well join. Wait a minute, hold off on the ventriloquism. Come in. Oh, Captain Super, good to see you.
Hi, fans.
As long as you're here, there's something I did want to ask you. People ask, what's Captain Super really like?
Certainly they ask. You know, Wallace, it's only natural for people to be curious about an internationally famous celebrity, especially when it's a hero like me. I'd be delighted to tell you all a little bit about myself.
Where shall we start?
How about with a quote from my high school yearbook, huh? That, of course, was Small Town High in Small Town, USA.
What was written?
Captain Super, swell personality, always ready to lend a helping hand, active in the model airplane club, was an assembly and hallway monitor, and manager of the intramural volleyball team.
Yeah, but what about captain of the football team and homecoming king?
Richie Lockerman got to be all that good stuff.
Richie Lockerman?
Yeah, it's Richie Lockerman. I really hated him. He got all the glory, the girls, thought he was the cat's pajamas just because he was a big man on campus.
Well, forget the past. Tell us about now, about Captain Super's private life.
Now?
People want to know.
Sorry, none of your beeswax.
But I might be able to get it in a fan mag.
That's different. I putter around the garden, tending to my tulips, spend at least an hour a day working on my memoirs. Wash and wax my 68 station wagon, then feed my tropical fish. Look, I'm just everyday folks like you when I'm off duty. Just a plain, ordinary, common joker like you sitting out there. It's no wonder you all identify with me. I'm your kind of people, huh? With one small difference.
Yeah?
I'm the greatest human being that ever lived. Oh, and Richie Lockerman, if you're out there, why don't you take a flying leap at a rolling donut, huh? You really burned me up.
You're out there, Richie. You're my kind of guy. So much for Captain Super. Time now for Ladmo and Spunky.
Well, Spunky, what's it going to be today? Come on, wake up.
The riddle routine.
Good idea. Go ahead. Ask me some riddles.
Do you know what has 2,754 seeds and moves by itself?
I give up.
Remote control fig.
That's pretty good. Let's have another riddle.
You know what has 18 legs, is covered with red spots, and catches flies?
I give up.
Baseball team with the measles.
It's funny stuff. It's funny. Come on, more.
You know how to top a car?
I give up. How do you top a car?
Tip on the brake, stupid.
That's good, Spunky. Good.
You know why Smokey the Bear wears a forest ranger's hat?
Why?
Just ate the ranger.
He's funny.
It's not like the first time you've heard these things.
It is. Good material.
You know it has 4 stander-uppers, 4 puller-downers, 2 hookers, 2 lookers, and a swishy-wishy?
Oh, I really give up on that one.
Cow.
It's funny. The cow and stuff.
You're so easily entertained, Ladmo.
I love it. More.
You know what's round and green, covered with blue hair, has big claws, weighs 500 pounds, and sings Come Back to Sorrento?
I give up.
Nothing. That's it, lad. Wrap it up.
Oh, okay. So long, folks. Good.
Well, he said he'd be back. Oh, here he is.
I'm back. What do you want?
Wanted to show you some photos here that the kids sent in. Oh, now, here's a picture of Gina's birthday party.
Hey, isn't that something? The cake and everything.
Lots of neat photos in the mail.
Uh-huh.
And here's a picture that Brian sent in. It looks like he's a little young for shaving, but it sure makes a nice-looking photograph there, doesn't it?
Yeah.
And here's a picture of Serenity getting ready for the big fishing trip.
Wow, look at that. Isn't that something?
We love getting pictures from the kids. Yeah. That's great.
Hey, well, I'm glad you showed it with me. I'll see you in a little while. I got to hurry up. I'll see you there.
He's off again. My goodness. Do you hear that? Hey, look who's back. It's Gerald.
I was standing out there waiting for him to leave.
Oh, Gerald, good to see you. How do you like the show so far?
Like a review?
Yes.
Corny, dumb, predictable, cluttered.
Cluttered?
Too many people. You don't need all those people.
Who are you talking about?
Captain Super, Marshall Good, the Wizard.
What about Ladmo?
Boring. All of it. The kids don't want that.
What do they want?
Tell you what they want. Me. Listen, just me. I'll sing, I'll dance, I'll play the harp.
Let me think about it. In the meantime, let's stick to our game plan. Here's Ladmo and Boppo the Clown.
Boring. Just boring.
Look how sad he looks. Bob, what? What's the sadness?
I made a decision.
A decision, huh?
I'm getting out of the clown biz.
Oh, why? What's wrong?
Attic gigs have been really falling off lately. Only one birthday party last month.
What?
Supermarket grand openings are down to a trickle and a nickel.
Jeez. Hey, you know what? I think I know what's wrong.
You gotta figure it out.
I gotta figure it out. I've been thinking about this very seriously.
Well, for gosh sakes, man, what is it? Tell me.
Well,
I'm desperate.
People don't like you because you're a crummy clown.
I could have gone all day without hearing an answer like that.
Yeah, but what you need is a new image. What's needed here is a big public relations job.
I am listening.
Okay, you got to come across as a nice guy. Then people will forget about what a jerk you are. Huh?
Okay, get on with it.
We'll get you involved in worthy causes. I can see the headlines now. Boffo donates time at hospital. Or how about Boffo gives hundreds of free birthday parties to deserving youngsters. Boffo gives free toys away to all the kids. Oh, I got got another one. Bafu puts on telethon for homeless puppies. Isn't that it? More, there's more, there's more. Bafu offers to donate money to New Children's Park, huh? This is a good one. Bafu hands over huge check to charity. Or Bob, Bafu gives all his worldly possessions to finance scientific research.
You're out of your mind.
Huh? But that's the new image.
I think I'll draw a picture.
Hey, Lynn, oh, there you are.
Hey, well, what? Have I any time?
Oh, yeah. I was going to show one of our films, but first I was going to just kind of draw a little picture here.
Picture, huh?
Yeah, I want you to see if you can tell what this is.
Oh.
Can you guess yet what this is?
It looks like, there's eyes.
Yeah.
There's a nose.
Yeah.
It looks like something, ooh.
What do you think?
That's hair.
It's some whiskers.
It's a lion.
You got it, Lammo. Okay, listen, I got a riddle for you.
A riddle?
Oh, yeah.
I like riddles.
Did you ever wonder why a giraffe, how does that go? Did you ever wonder why
the head?
A giraffe's neck is so long?
Oh, I don't know why.
All right, you know what I think the problem is trying to draw and talk at the
same time?
Yeah, the reason is, it's because his neck is so long. Because his head is so far from his body.
That's it. That's it. Because his head is so far from his body.
Now take a trip to the zoo to see all of the animals.
Oh,
the poor giraffe and eyeball there.
Proud.
Visit the zoo and see all the animals. Let's turn on the time machine. We'll move the dial back to 1870 and see who we meet.
All right. Right over here, yes. Put that cage over there and close the door.
Why, it's
P.G. Barnum, my boy. Yes, P.G. Barnum, the man who originated the circus. Later, hooked up with Bailey, then with Ringling Brothers, but it was me who started it all, my little TV MC.
How did it all begin?
Funny you should ask, yes. It all started out quite by accident. Seems I was out of work, had lots of mouths to feed. Family of mine was enough to drive a man to drink, and I never stopped to thank them either.
Tell us about your family.
Large family, large, yes. There was my Aunt Edna, huge woman, gigantic, weighed 400 pounds.
Yes?
My nephew Thurman was there, big boy, strong as an ox, could lift anything.
Go on.
Well, let's not forget my cousin Buster. Strange twerp, only 2 feet high.
Only 2 feet high, eh?
Yes. If I said it must be so. 2 feet.
Who else?
There's my brother Elmo. Loved animals, Elmo did. Brought home lions, lizards, llamas.
Animals, I got a riddle for you. You know why a giraffe's neck is so long?
Yes, because his head is so far away from his body.
Oh, you've heard it before. Must be an old joke. Go on. I'm sorry to interrupt you. We're talking about your family.
Yes. Let's see. Where was I? My crazy Uncle Bonzo. Always clowning around. Always the life of the party. Wore lampshade, rolled up his pants leg, that sort of thing.
It's quite a family.
The neighbors certainly thought so.
Oh, they did?
Right. Yes. They used to come by, look in the window.
What did you do?
Charged them each a dime.
You did?
Yes.
I figured I'd make him pay to see P.T. Barnum's family. So successful, I bought a tent. We went on the road. Let me tell you, they came by the thousands to see Edna the Fat Lady, Thurman the Strong Man, Buster the Midget, Elmo the Animal Trainer, and Bonzo the Clown.
There's a sucker born every minute.
Say, wait a minute. Yeah. That's not bad. I think I'll use that. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Inside the big top, the show is about to begin. Yes, all of the wonders of nature, sights the man is not supposed to see. They're all right back here. The one tend to be down. Join
us. Is it okay to come out?
Oh, we'll turn it on again. We'll go in the past on the next show and see who we can meet, some famous person in history. I like turning on the time machine.
Hello? Hey, boy, it's me, Gladmo.
Oh, hey, where are you?
Well, I'm going over to the theater to see Mike and Meyer. You know those vaudeville guys?
The guys trying to bring back vaudeville.
Yeah, that's it, that's it. I'm going to go see them for a while.
All right.
Okay, see you in a little bit.
Okay, goodbye.
Bye.
Well, why don't we do that? Why don't we see what Muck and Meyer are up to, their latest routine?
Muck and Meyer.
I'm Meyer.
Zay Meyer.
Uh-huh.
Do you have a job on the side to keep you going between these vaudeville gates?
Well, you bet, Muck. I'm an elevator operator.
Good job?
Oh, it has its ups and downs, ups and downs.
Wait a minute. Yeah, You're not the only one working.
You got a job?
I've got a job, too.
Oh, really? Well, tell us about it.
I'm a mechanic at a candy factory.
What does a mechanic at a candy factory do?
I tighten the nuts on the peanut brittle.
Say, Muck, did you see the morning paper?
No, what's in it?
My lunch.
Wow!
More.
Funny, funny guy. I love this character. I'm telling you that right now. But wait a minute. If you grab sandwiches in the paper instead of reading it, how are you ever going to know anything?
Well, I know all about the big race.
What race?
The human race.
Wait a minute. What are you laughing at? What are you laughing at? The human race. You're not in it.
I'm not in the
Gotcha!
So much for Muck and Meyer. Well, Gerald, that's it for today. How did you like the show?
Oh, I couldn't. It was one of the worst experiences I've ever been through. In fact, it made me physically ill. I'm so sick. I got to lie down. Please keep it. I'm very sensitive, and I'm telling you, the fragile.
Yeah, you take it easy and rest for... You take it easy and rest for a little bit.
Okay. Hey, gang, tune in next time for the Wallace and Ladmo Show. Hey! Hope you enjoy the show. See you real soon. Hey! Goodbye, everybody! Hey.